Today's project, we are creating a professional logo. We're using shapes, we're using circles, we are doing things professional, we're coming up with crazy ideas. Before we jump in on our project, a shout out to Blessing, who just reminded me why I'm doing what I'm doing. She said that she went to Fiverr and she couldn't afford the logo there because it was expensive for her online store. And for me, this is exactly why I opened this channel. For small business owners who don't have the budget yet, I'm not saying don't go buy a logo. I know that it's expensive because I felt exactly the same way when I started. And then she found the channel and she found the logo and she was saying big ups to the channel. Thank you so much, Blessing. I appreciate the feedback. I hope you're going to subscribe and I hope you're going to watch lots of videos and grow your online store using the content that I put out there. Enough talking. Let's jump in on the logo and go. Canva is still my number one tool when it comes to designing logos. And after you've opened up your canvas, then you're going today in this video, we're using shapes and lines to create a professional logo. And you could use it for any kind of business. But if you're thinking lines and you're thinking round shapes, you are at the right video. Once you land on your blank canvas, press C for circle or go to your shapes and look for circle. And after you've created your circle, you're gonna make it make the circle bigger and then just size it and make it a bit large. Then we're going to change the color of the circle and we're going to make it blue, and we're going to duplicate the shape and change that to white, and then we're going to reduce it like that. Then we're going to press rectangle for a square shape, change the color of that and make it white so that you can create that nice gap between the two sides of your circle, so that it creates that nice gap and like that ivory shape kind of a design that we're looking for. Next, you're going to press L for line and you're going to change the size of your L and make that large, like a 30, and change the color of that line to a sky blue. Rotate that and use your lines quite nicely to align them on your circle to create that nice looking design. I can hear the demons call when they do what they do, and now I feel like taking off, find a place with a view. The pain is never gonna stop if it's controlling you. I know the time can... Depending on what you would like to create, so you could be creating a plumber's logo and you could have the end of the lines look like a pipe. So it is up to you where you play around with the designs, and then it suits whatever kind of design you're creating. So it looks quite professional and sophisticated and absolutely gorgeous. It is just not aligned. So let's align it. And you know, when you go to file and you go to rulers, so you can use the rulers as well as your margins to make sure that you are completely aligned with your design. Next, you're going to press T for text and then add text of the company as well as the tagline of your logo. So I'm gonna press T. I'm a robot, I'm in my own skin. Never get lost when thoughts pull you in. I miss the old you. We died with a purpose, all the energy around me felt. What I'm going to do with this one, I'm just gonna duplicate the text and then create a second line and then have that nice 3D-ish look on that I want to create here. And the last thing, I will create the tagline. And there you go. There's your 2D logo on Canva. What we're going to do now, we're going to download this as a transparent background, and then we're going to upload it back on Canva to take away all of the whites that we've added on this design. Download it. We're going to add an extra page. Drag the download back to Canva. As you can see, when it's uploading, it has that extra white. To get rid of that, we're going to click on edit image. We do the background remover so that it takes away the white. If you don't have Canva Pro, you're more than welcome to go trial it for 30 days using my link below. If you trialed it and you know what, you don't like it, that's also okay. You can use remove.bg or erase.bg. Once you're done, you're going to click on apply, and then we're going to download our beautiful, amazing, professional simple minimalistic logo, and then we're going to jump in on Photopea and convert this to a 3D. You're going to go www.photopea.com, and then you will access the online editor that's available for free. You're then going to click on PSD templates. If you want to use your own template, that's also okay. You must just use the open from computer process. I'll link one of my videos below so that you can follow that process. I would love to use the glass effect logo mockup, and you're going to select it and then click on photopea.com, and it loads the mockup. Once your logo mockup has been uploaded, you're going to double click where it says your logo here, but where it is checkered box. It would either say your logo here or your design here or logo here. Just where you see it says your design here or some sort of those terms, you double click on that. And then you hide the text. Once that's done, you click and you drag your design, and it loads quite nicely. You can size it and make it big if you like. And then you're going to press Command S to convert it to a smart object. And then you're going to click on Glass Effect Logo to convert it to 3D. Comment below, like the video. Tell people about the video and the channel so that I can also grow. Yes, go buy my courses so I can also continue doing the work that I do to help the upcoming designers that we've been helping. Thank you so much for joining me for this tutorial. I will see you on the next video.